This video is brought to you by Make It Simple TT. We also offer SBA and IA assistance and paper 3 guidance for students who are doing the subjects as extra subjects and may not be in a school. They may also not be getting the required amount of attention in their school due to different circumstances. Closer to exams, a dedicated SBA and IA class is held to get anyone who needs help over the finish line. To register, head over to our website at makeitsimplett.com/register, or you can WhatsApp 1-868-308-8799. Chavi was nominated to serve as a team lead for the planning of an ICT symposium. List 3 groups of ICT-related personnel that Chavi will need to invite to the symposium. So let me tell you how you deal with this kind of problem. When you read a question like this and you're like, what, list 3 groups of IT personnel that you would invite to the symposium? Stop. Read through the rest of the question. It will serve you better to kind of understand what direction the question is going at and how you might be required to answer when you look at it. So let's check again. So state 2 ways in which the extensive use of ICT has positively impacted the field of business. All right, cool. So they want to know about IT and businesses. Chavi was asked to prepare a memorandum for the Director General outlining the plans of the symposium. Okay, this might help us. The follows an extract in a Word document. So there's an interestingly connected world infrastructure each country, to understand how the attacker works, to know what to look for within the data infrastructure. It is recommended that the participants have responsibility to the following networks, network communication and infrastructure. It is recommended that they have prior knowledge of basic Windows commands, basic threats, security, and internet response. All right, so based on the things that they have in this letter here, this gives us a little clue as to what the question might be asking for part one. So I could kind of get a gauge of, okay, ICT related personnel. You see they have the word network inside here, networks, Linux commands, firewall, security, internet response. So we're looking at people like a network administrator, then network technician, and a systems analyst, right? All of those fields will most likely be used in a business, especially if your business is doing like networking stuff, right? Any others, they probably need somebody who is a systems administrator because they need Windows commands, so you could put systems administrator. All right, state 2 ways in which the extensive use of ICT has positively impacted the field of business. Okay, efficiency of delivery, easier hiring processes, all sorts of different things will fit inside there. So e-commerce, advertising online, hiring of staff. Basically, once you could link it back to a business, that's easy. This is a subjective answer. You're not really going to lose marks unless you write something like, you know, potato, which you shouldn't do. All right, so now Chavez asked to prepare a memorandum, which is basically a memo. A memorandum is like a document, right? All right, following is an extract of the memorandum prepared using the Word format. So state 1 reason for using bullets and numbering in a Word document: to make things easier to read/follow. Other than bullets and numbering, identify 2 formatting features using the extract of the memorandum. Oh gosh, we didn't have to look back. It has something here that's underlined. We have something here that is in bold, italics, and left align. Describe how the positions of paragraph 1 and 2 from the extract can be interchanged using drag and drop feature. Alright, so step 1. So it's 3 marks, so we basically looking for 3 steps. Step 1, highlight paragraph 1. Click on the highlighted portion of the text. Drag and drop after the last line of paragraph 2. So this is a way that you could do cut and paste, but it's not using the actual cut function. You actually highlighting the data and just dragging it across the highlighting the whole paragraph and dragging it from one part of the page to the next part of the page. All right, describe the steps used in conducting a spell check on a Word document. 4 whole marks to describe the steps on how to do a spell check. Step 1, click menu, spelling and grammar. Step 2, compare suggested word with your wood, click replace or replace all. 3, click next and repeat until done. They're basically asking you, okay, what do you do when it's time to do a spell check? All right, what they've given us now is a programming question, because they know they had to mix in programming. So the last two questions, questions 3 and 4, they had to put some programming on the inside in there. So remember, you cannot get tested on code. They cannot test you on code. All they can test you on is pseudocode and algorithms. So the pseudocode below will calculate the output and output the number of participants and the average age of all participants attending the ICT symposium. So we're still working with the same scenario. The algorithm will determine and display the output when the age of 999 is entered. Okay, so 999 is what you're using to stop the program. Okay. Complete the following pseudocode by filling in the blank spaces labeled 1 to 10 with the most appropriate variables and or reserved words. So, we don't have to write out the whole pseudocode. All we have to do is complete it. We have set count, set age, set average, set total. So we have 4 variables: count, age, average, and total, all of them setting at 0. And what we are trying to do is we are trying to find the average age of all the participants. So they're going to be putting in their age over and over and over and over and over. And what we want to do is we want to calculate the average age. So let's try. So enter participants' age. What would we have to do to get to do this? Usually you have to prompt the person, because they realize the read comes right after, right? So we have to prompt. So we're going to print enter participants age, because that's basically how you're going to get the participant. Because remember, they are going to see this program as if you wrote it. So if you wrote it, you want to put on the screen print participants age, right? And now they told us that the value that we're going to stop at is 999. So we want to say while age is not equal to 999, do set total is equal to total plus age. So this here is going to keep our running total of the age. So whatever age I got is going to add it back to total and then store the answer inside total. That's basically age. So now we want to keep track of the count. So how much times we want to keep track of how many count times the count is taking place. So we're gonna say count is equal to count plus 1, right? That's how you use a counter. If you don't know how to do these things, go and check my website. And then we have to say set something is equal to total divided by count. What we are actually doing here is they said that they want to find the average. Now, I don't agree with calculating the average inside the loop. When you calculate the average inside the loop, that doesn't really make too much sense to me, because you should just do the loop and calculate the average at the end of it. But they want you to do that way? Cool, no problem. The variable we want to set here is average. Right, set average to total divided by count. The reason we're doing that is because the count is going to go up to a particular number, the total is going to go up to a number, and when they divide the total that you have by the amount of times the loop has run, then you will be able to get the average. As I said, if you don't understand what I'm saying right now, I can't explain it, because I'm just working out the past paper. If you need to understand how to do loops and algorithms, go to the website, check the playlist, and watch all 7 of the videos, and I guarantee you, you'll understand this question a lot better, right? So after we get average is equal to total divided by count, next thing you have to do is write. So they use write. Okay, so then we could probably use write up here too. Enter another age or 999 to terminate the program. So what we want to read here is we want to read age. So we read any age before the loop is finished. Once we read that age, then 7 is probably end while. But they kind of do that stupid, because look where the while loop starting and it indented there. So if the while loop starting here, then the end while should actually end here. Yeah. So this really supposed to be like starting there. If you follow the rules of indentation, but I mean, obviously they want us to follow the rules of indentation, but they won't do that in their question, will they? No, right? We do the end while. Now after the end while, meaning that once the while loop does it what it's supposed to do, it will go through this whole process here over and over and over and over and over and over and over, as long as the person doesn't put in 999. Once the person puts in 999, then it will print out the answers that we wanted to get. The number of participants are, this will be stored in a variable called count, because every single time the loop runs, we are carrying up the count by 1. So that makes sense. And then write the average age of the participants. The average age of the participants are any variable will be called average. And then the last thing now would be stop.
This video is brought to you by Make It Simple TT. With the easiest registration available, all you have to do is fill out a form on our website, and an automated email process will allow you to pay for your classes via credit or debit card, PayPal, or local bank transfers. With same-day processing within working hours, you'll be in your virtual classroom in less than an hour in some cases. To register, head over to our website at makeitsimplett.com/register, or you can WhatsApp 1-868-308-8799.